Victor Rookwood is dead. He confronted me as I left Ollivander's with the Keeper's wand. I had to defend myself.
Godric's heart, are you all right? I know you're well able to defend yourself. I've seen it often enough. But Rookwood himself...
He destroyed so many lives and wouldn't have stopped. I'm glad I was able to put an end to him.
You're right. He wouldn't have stopped. You did what you had to do. The wizarding community owes you a great debt.
Thank you for saying so, Professor. I'm ready for what's next.
All right, then. The Keepers have been waiting.
You have completed all of our trials, and you have done so under circumstances even I did not foresee. You understand now why all of this was necessary. The portkey, the vault, the locket, the book, the trials. To ensure that one with the ability you and I share would make the same choice that Zahn, Neve, Charles, and I did.
Now that you have witnessed my memory, you understand all that is at stake. Not everyone is what they seem.
As you know, light does not exist without shadow, nor shadow without light. Simply because you can eliminate darkness does not always mean that you should.
Even the most well-meaning and competent amongst us cannot possibly know the consequences of manipulating what should be beyond our reach.
What lies in the repository must never be released. Resist the temptation to destroy or control it. The magic that you have so carefully honed must now be used only to protect the secret we keep. You have the wand. You will know when to wield it. We leave our legacy in your hands.
Astonishing.
That must be the way to the repository.
We can only hope that we're not too late, and that we find nothing but a repository undisturbed beyond this door.
I should hope that the enchantments protecting the castle would protect against an incursion from below.
I fear they will not. Although, if... Damn, the goblins!
I wonder if Ranrok is... Were you able to reach Professor Weasley?
If his loyalists are here, he cannot be far behind.
You and I have faced worse, Professor.
Ranrok will be pleased with our progress.
Yeah.
Ranrok must be here somewhere.
This drill stands between us and him. We need to move it.
I shall handle it. One moment. Let's go. Must be getting closer to finding the repository.
I fear you're right, Professor. There's nothing we can do but keep searching.
Lumos!
Listen, more goblins up ahead.
Not your best friend.
What have we?
We're getting closer, Professor. That way.
The goblins have somehow evaded the castle's defensive charms.
Lead them this way! We shall make quick work of them!
They got this.
We're in the thick of it now.
We'll show these beasts who's in charge. Your timing couldn't be better, Professor Hecate.
Thank you, Professor. Such power!
Hurry up! Upward
with the sky, Hogwarts!
Take
him! Ranrok will get it!
I won't rest!
Quickly!
believe we got here before Ranrok.
I can't believe this is it. The repository has been under the castle for hundreds of years.
Think of all the pain that created it. This is what Miriam, George, your friend Lodgok, and countless others died for. Miriam believed this forgotten magic could be used for such good. But she did not know the risks. She did not see what the Keepers have shown you. What Isidora showed you. You are now the Keeper of whatever power it holds. What do you intend to do with it?
I've decided to open the repository. Its power cannot lie dormant for centuries more.
After everything you've seen, what about Isidora's fate?
Isidora wasted her ability trying to save people from themselves. I will not let others dictate what I do with this. My power.
You cannot possibly mean that. You, of all wizard kind, are wholly aware of the misery and pain that that could cause.
The arrogance of wizard kind. Goblins built this repository. It belongs to us.
Enough, Ranrok. It was never yours.
I've been wanting to play with this.
Miriam's wand.
If she'd simply handed over the container, all of this could have been avoided. Foolish, self-important witch. Seems you were two of a kind. She didn't know when to give up either.
Thank you. Stop me!
Thank you.
Thank you, Miriam. For everything.
Professor Eleazar Fig. I dare say he was a beloved professor to many of you, certainly a long-standing colleague to his peers. A famed adventurer and seeker of knowledge, he built a reputation charging into the unknown, brazenly disregarding both discretion and safety, providing perhaps a rather unfortunate lesson for us all. His devotion to adventure was rivaled only by his dedication to Hogwarts. And of course, to his wife, Miriam, whom we lost much too soon as well.
Professor Fig represented the best of all of us. Oh, he could be deviously clever, possessed a brilliantly inquisitive mind, and was the most loyal of friends. But perhaps it was his remarkable courage, for which we will all be forever indebted to him. If not for Professor Fig, well, I can say with confidence that if not for him, many of us, let alone Hogwarts, would not be here today. Those that knew him best will agree that we must now honor him as only Hogwarts can, by wisely, resourcefully, justly, and bravely facing all that lies ahead.
To Professor Fig!
Meet me as soon as possible. I received an interesting owl from...
Can't believe we lost Fig. I didn't know him as well as you did, but I know he was a good man. Glad Weasley spoke for him. She honored him well. Fig will be well remembered. I wish the same could have been done for my uncle. I wonder if there's a chance Anne would meet me.
Sebastian, I can't imagine what you and Anne are going through. Perhaps you'll hear from her soon.
I hope so. I'll let you know.
Sebastian, there's something you should know. It's to do with Victor Rookwood.
I heard a rumor that he confronted you outside of Ollivander's. Sounds as if he faced quite a fight.
The rumors are true, and I did. But it's not that. Just before Rookwood attacked, he uttered something familiar. The same words Anne heard before she was cursed. Children should be seen and not heard.
Wait! What are you saying?
It wasn't one of Ranrok's loyalists who cursed Anne. It was Rookwood. It was Rookwood all along.
This can't be. It was the loyalists. It's always been them. The night Anne was cursed, all she saw were goblins.
Once Rookwood allied with Ranrok, Isidora's estate became of interest to them both. That's why Rookwood was there the night Anne was cursed. He was working with Ranrok. When he saw your sister, well, he didn't want anyone to know.
So he cursed her, and she's never been the same. So cruel. Rookwood deserved what he got. Thank you for telling me. It wasn't a goblin. I suppose I owe you an apology. All this time I thought goblins were the enemy. But it was never that simple. Ominous said he's spoken with Anne. I wonder if she'll see me. I'll find out and send word when I know more.
Thoughts about what you told me in the Great Hall. I would like to speak with you. Meet me in the Undercroft as soon as you can.
Velio. Handy resource indeed, your field guide.
Been having strange dreams of late.
Revelio.
Just the person I was hoping to see.
I see Doran finally convinced you to leave the Snidgets.
If anyone can keep them out of poacher hands, it's the centaurs. And I wanted to thank you. When the poachers ambushed us, it was nice not to face them alone.
Of course. It's the sort of thing friends do for each other, isn't it?
I suppose so. I am glad you came to Hogwarts. It's already been my best year. I wouldn't want a repeat of Horntail Hall, of course, but I did enjoy the Three Broomsticks. Had no idea how lovely it was there.
Had you never been to the Three Broomsticks?
I used to spend most of my time with Highwing, and well, I don't know how Serona feels about hippogriffs popping in for a butterbeer. Highwing's the only one I would have gone with. Or Gran, of course.
Nothing wrong with that. Highwing's good company.
She is. Although I am beginning to see the appeal of, human friends. It was nice to talk about my parents and Gran with someone. And share Highwing.
Does your Gran know that we found the Snidgets?
I couldn't hold it in any longer. I told her everything. She was livid that I'd been anywhere near the poachers. But she confessed that she was rather envious about the Snidgets.
It has all been a pleasure, Poppy. Do try and stay out of trouble.
Don't know that I can. We've taken on poachers twice now, successfully. I rather think you've helped me develop a taste for it. And with centaurs as allies, I might actually go looking for trouble. You and I should meet for a butterbeer soon. Perhaps Highwing can join us?
Someone as young as me could save my uncle's life.
No idea how you found yourself involved in the failed coup beneath the castle, but you didn't lose the battle, so well done. I suppose.
Often asks after you and his owls.
Leave it to Binns to make the most interesting school in the world seem dull.
Hello, Adelaide. How are you and your uncle doing?
Very well, thanks to you. The more I learn about Ranrok's foul lot, the more astounded I am that my uncle survived. I looked back over his old owls and noticed that they included pertinent details about his rare metal deposits. I believe that Ranrok's fiends were after those deposits and that they needed my uncle's knowledge. He was willingly going to rot away in that cell to keep me safe.
It was nothing at all, Adelaide. I'm just glad your uncle's safe.
So am I. Seeing him again was such a relief. I told him that he must remain vigilant from now on. I, for one, can't help but look over my shoulder now whenever I leave the castle grounds. Yes.
Revelio.
Eyes on me, musicians. We're about to begin our life is behind me.
Now what am I supposed to do?
I can't believe we found ourselves trapped in that scriptorium. Never again.
Getting away with this, he has another thing coming.
What as well be surrounded by Jarvis?